Hi, I'm Ramaya Salgadu, and I'm the program analyst for UN Women in Sri Lanka. I think our social indicators don't necessarily convey the true story of the situation of women in country. One of the lagging areas is women's participation in politics. Since 1930s, we have had no further than 5.8% in parliament. This is something that really needs to increase given the time and age we are in right now. UN Women, through the generous support of the Royal Norwegian Embassy, has worked through its implementing partners, Association of War-Affected Women, the Women and Media Collective, and Search for Common Ground, to begin very preliminary steps around the discourse on women's political participation. And some of our most salient initiatives was perhaps the dialogue with political leadership, where we've advocated to ensure the nominations are a little bit more inclusive and that we have more women on their list, because as we have understood, it doesn't matter even if we have quotas. What really matters is that parties understand the importance of engaging more women, and it is visible through their nomination list. We had approximately 20 regional consultations, and all the women's organizations that participated in these consultations submitted to the Public Reforms Committee on Constitutional Reforms, and it was picked up in their final report. And we hope that these will be reflected in the new constitution that we hope will be seen next year. We also done gender responsive budgeting, and you know, as mentioned earlier, financing is a huge issue even when women want to participate in elections in the political sphere, because you're expected to come with some financial backing. And gender responsive budgeting is ensuring essentially that women are considered in the planning and budgeting processes, and it is also to ensure that some of their requirements are adhered to or financed adequately. We have also worked with the Parliamentary Women's Caucus to strengthen their capacities to support them through policy and research so that they can advocate for women within the parliament. We've also helped develop their strategic plan for 2016, and we hope to hope that this is a long-term partnership that we will carry forward beyond the Royal Norwegian Embassy project.
I'm Sarah Bibler. I'm the Operations Officer for the International Foundation for Electoral Systems, IFES, in Sri Lanka. So women's political participation is essential in Sri Lanka. Women make up over 50% of the population, but are less than 2% of the local level representatives. And we believe that democracy can't flourish unless citizens are fully represented as decision makers, men and women, as well as diverse groups. So we believe that the adoption of the local level quota is a critical opportunity to promote women as elected leaders and as decision makers, and pave the way for a more gender inclusive electoral environment.
I'm Abdul Majid Nilamuddin.
Women Caucus conducted training programs for women to empower them in politics, to motivate them to involve in politics.
I'm Nawaz Mohammed. UN Women do initiatives that are complementing the larger efforts that are happening in Sri Lanka around, you know, gender and governance, and with specific focus to women's political participation.
So my name is Ashani Basnayaka. I work at Verite Research. In Parliament, generally, there's very low levels of participation. So even though there's 6% even representation, the actual engagement of this cohort of 13 women is quite low. And what was found is they need the assistance. Following the discussions with these women, we know for a fact that one or two of them have actually started engaging more as a result of the work we've done. which is quite heartening to see.
Mama Sudharma Pulathunga, Vishesham me Vedasatahana Pradeshi Mattamin Samvidhana Karapu Sampadharin Saha, me Vedasatahanta Sahabhagi Vecha Kantavangin, Api me Vedasatahane Gunados, Emunata Om Labhagat Adhyakim, Mehi Thiyena Vatinakam Pilibandawa, Ratema Asannanta Api Denuwath Karanna Puluwankamak Thibuna.
Mama Chandrika Adisulsa, Maharagama Nagara Sabhave Hitupu Nagarika Mantri, UN Women Ayathanayen Mulya Anugrahaya Labha Dila, Search for Common Ground ආයතනයේ හොඳ අපිට සම්පත්දාරි ඒ කමට මේ අපි කරන වැඩසටහන් වලට මේ දැනුම ලබා දෙන්න මේ සම්පත්දාරි අපිට දෙනවා.
විසාක ධර්මදාස, heading the Association of War Affected Women, the project that we partner with UN Women, enhancing or increasing women's political participation, we are still working on that project in the sense that these kind of things are not projectized.
My name is Sarah Arumugam. The initiatives that we started with them in working in regional networks, that was very meaningful because we were able to strengthen them in their regions. And they were able to have connections with their other sisters in their community.
I'm Sepali Kottagoda, the Executive Director of the Women and Media Collective. UN Women very readily responded to our request in the constitutional reform process that was taking place this year. So we were able to actually bring in the voices of women from 20 odd districts. When the Public Representation Committee on constitutional reform had embarked on hearings with the public across the country.
So we asked that the constitution ensures that the state brings in affirmative action provisions to ensure at least a third of women's representation at parliament, at the level of provincial council, and at the level of local government.
අපි ප්‍රශ්න ගොඩක් තියෙනවා. ඉතින් මේ වගේ ආරක්ෂා වෙලා නිදහසේ ජීවත් වෙන්න තියෙන කාන්තාවන්ට තියෙන අයිතිය විවස්ථාවේ ඇතුළත් වෙන්න ඕනේ අපිට එහෙම ආයතන විවස්ථාවෙම හිමි වෙන්න ඕනේ කාන්තාවන් මේ රටේ ගෞරවනීය කාන්තාවන් ජීවත් වෙන්න පුළුවන් පරිසරයක් ගොඩනැගෙන්න ඕනේ ඒක ප්‍රධාන වශයෙන් ආපු එක
I think there are multiple stakeholders that have been working on women's political participation, the increase of women's political participation for decades. Some of our partners have been working on it for as long as 25 years. The government, very specifically the Ministry of Women and Child Affairs, Ministry of Provincial and Local Government have been working a lot to ensure that there are quotas in place and that there are trained women who can fill these seats in within the local government. But there can be a lot of advocacy and a lot of initiatives to train women post elections, pre elections, and you know, develop their capacities. But we really need a push from the very top in some kind of indication that Sri Lanka is very real about the need for women's political participation, to see more women in decision making roles, and for it not to just be tokenistic. And I think right now we're at a pivotal moment in our political history where, there for the first time ever, we have quota at local government level. Of course, local government is the very lowest level, but it is a beginning. Now, I think, is the time for key stakeholders to come together to sort of make full use of this quota that is in place and to ensure that women, capacitated, knowledgeable, and you know, fully ready to take on a role that I think in a very informal way they have been doing all their lives.